Hello, good afternoon to everyone. Today's topic of the engineering material code is 25C, that is the forging process. Actually, forging process is one of the manufacturing process in which practically all materials which are not used in the cast form are the reduced or the some standard shape for the subsequent processing. So here we discuss the topics, today's lectures, introduction and the objectives of the forging, classification of the forging processes, calculation of the forging loads, effects for the effects of the forging on the microstructures, residual stresses in the forging, and typical forging defects. So firstly, we take the introduction of the forging. Actually, forging is the working of the metal into the useful shape by the hammering or the pressing. So this is the oldest method of the metal working art, or it is also called the primitive blacksmithy. So it is the oldest method since from 400 BC, and that time this process is used to manufacture the tools, equipment and the weapons which is used in wars. Today's replacement of the machinery occurred during earlier industrial revolution. The forging machines are now capable for the making the part ranging in the size of the bolt of a turbine rotor. The most forging operations are carried out hot, although certain metal may be cold formed. So here it is the in the diagram there it is the metal of the red hot in condition in the furnace and ready for the hammering or the pressing work. Now the objective of this subject, the fundamental of the metal working process for the forging, in order to understand mathematically approach used in the calculation of applied forging load required to cause plastic deformation to give the final product, classification of the metal forging methods is also provided with the description of the defects observed from the forging process. The solution of the tactile such defects will also be addressed. Now the forging operations. Here it is the three forging operations. First is aging, second is drawing, and the third one is piercing and the punching operation. In the first diagram we can see here it is the two dies. These are the two dies, one is stationary and one is the movable, and both are the used to shave the end of the brass and to gather the metal. The metal is flow in the confined in the horizontal direction. Here it is the horizontal direction, but it is the field to flow laterally to fill the this die, and its final shape is in the circular or the elliptical shape. Here it is used to modify the edge of the bars or the cylindrical bars or rectangular bars, and here it is the example such as the bolts or the screws. And the second one is the drawing, is used to reduce the cross-sectional area of the workpiece with the concurrent increasing the length. Here it is the diameter of this rod, initial diameter, and here it is the reduce the diameter with the help of the drawing process. Here it is the two dies. So here it is the push up this rod in the two dies and increase the length. And the piercing process, here it is used for the produce the hole in the metal plate.
So here it is the hollow space, and here it is the with the help of punch we can produce the hole in the metal plate. So this is the forging operation. Next is the furring is used to reduce the cross sectional area of the portion of the shop the metal is flow is outward and any way from the center of the fuller. That is the forging is the connecting rod for an internal combustion engine. So these are the two dies. Suppose this is the dies and here it is the firstly it is cut up to the center and it is fullering by the fuller, and these are the fullers. It is apply the perpendicular movement and the fast movement of the metal which is perpendicular to its face. So here it is the motion of the fuller and here it is the surface of the metal. So finally we obtain this type of surface, and these are the fuller of the different shapes. It is the hammer like shape. So here is the picturical view of this fuller. Forging operations in this the saging is used to produce a bar with a smaller diameter using the concave dies. Here it is the concave dies is used for the saging process. The saging is a special type of forging in which the metal is formed by the succession of the rapid hammer blow. And here it is saving is provided to reduce the round cross sectional area suitable for the tapping, threading, upsetting or other subsequent forming and the machining operations. Classification of the forging process. Here it is by the two types of the classification of forging process by the equipments and according to the process. So by equipments, here as we explain the forging process with the help of hammer, the forging hammers and the drop hammers, okay, and the press forging with the help of machining, and the by the process. These are the two processes, the open die forging process and close, this is also the die forging process. So here these are the machine press forging process. First one is for the drop hammer. This is the drop hammer. This is the anvil on which the die and the workpiece is held. And this is the rammer and this is the board which is operate with the help of rollers. Here it is the screw press, again it is anvil and these are two dies and this is ram, and ram is operate with the help of the screw. And here it is the flywheel and this is the rotating wheel. So here it is rotate like that and the screw is moved up and down and press the workpiece. And in the crank press process, here it is the crank is used in place of the flywheel or the screw system. Here it is the crank and the connecting rod is used, and this is the ram and move with the help of the crank and connecting rod and press the workpiece. And in the fourth diagram, here it is the hydraulic fluid is used to impact the object with the help of ram. So here it is the fluid flowing piston cylinder arrangement is there, and here it is the table of the load reading, available energy and the ratio. And the drop hammer is obtaining the 12,250 kilonewton load, and the available energy from this is 1.6, and ratio is the ratio of F. F is to fire, H is to F. Okay, F is the load rating and H is the available energy. So here it is the ratio of W is to F, sorry, and the 1.3 is the ratio. and the friction screw press in this second, by the second machine, the load will be same, but the available energy is 8.0 and the ratio will be 6.4. And the crank press, the load rating 12,250, which is same, and the available energy from this is 220 kilojoule, and the 16 meter is the ratio, and the hydraulic press is load rating is same, and the available energy from this is 250, and the 200 is the ratio. So it means the hydraulic press is the more generate the energy with the same loading rate. Hammer and the press forging process. The forging hammers, and forging presses, there are the two basics of the forging hammer use. First one is the bold hammer and the second is the power hammer. The forging press, there is a two basic type of the forging pressing available, the mechanical pressing and the hydraulic pressing. So here it is, we explain one by one. The first is the bold hammer forging process. The upper die, here it is the upper die, and it is the ram or the base by the friction roller. These are the friction rollers which is gripping the board. This is the board rod, and these are the two roller which is the gripping this board and rise up and down by the upper die. This is the upper die, this is workpiece, and this is the lower die, and anvil on which the lower die is placed. So this is the board hammer. After releasing the board, the ram fall under the gravity to produce the low energy. The hammer can be strike between the 60 to 150 blows per minute depending upon the size and capacity. The bold hammer is the energy restricted machine. The low energy supplied equal to the potential energy due to the weight and the height of falls. So here we know that the potential energy is equals to the product of mass and acceleration due to gravity and the height. So this is energy will be delivered to the metal workpiece to produce the plastic deformation. So this is the bond hammer, forging hammer. Now the second is the forging hammer or the drop hammer type, which is the operate with the help of belt and the pulleys. The provide the rapid impact blow to the surface of the metal. The dies are the two halves. The upper half is fixed to the anvil. The lower half is fixed to the anvil, and upper half is moved up and down with the help of belt. The energy from the gravity is absorbed into the metal, in which the maximum impact is on the metal surface. The die are the expensive being accurately machine on the special alloy. Drop the forging is good for the mass production of the complex shapes. So this is the picture critical view of the new launch machines of the forging. So here it is. The energy supplied by the blow is used to the potential energy due to the weight of the ram and the height of the falls. So this is the machine in which the ram is moved with the help of belt and pulley with the same potential energy. This is the power hammer. The power hammer is provide great capacity in which the ram is accelerated on the downstroke by the steam or the air pressure in addition to the gravity. So steam and the air pressure is also used to raise the ram and on the upstroke. The total energy supplied to the blow in the power drop is given by this formula. So W is equals to 1 by 2 mv square, that is the kinetic energy, and the pah, the and which is equals to the mg plus pah. The m here, it is the m is the mass of the ram, and v is the velocity of the ram at the start of the deformation, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and the p is the pressure of the air and the steam acting on the ram on the cylinder, which is going downward, and a is the area of the ram and the height of the ram from which it is drawn. So this is the power hammer. So here it is, the steam is inserted from this side and go from this side where it is moved downward. When it is moved upward, then the steam is coming from this side and go outside from this side. So this is operated with the help of steam or the air pressure. Now the next one is the hydraulic press forging. In this, using the hydraulic press or a mechanical press to forge the metal before giving the continuous forming at the slower rate, providing the deeper penetration, better properties, more homogeneous, like the equipment is expensive than the power hammer. And here it is, the hydraulic fluid is used to operate the ram. When the ram is going up and down with the help of this pressurized, high pressurized fluid. Okay, and these are the two die, and here it is the metal, and this is the arrangement of the hydraulic press forging. This is the visual view of the hydraulic press, are the load restricted machines in which the hydraulic pressures move piston in the cylinder. The full pressure loaded is available at any point during the full stroke of the ram. Therefore, the hydraulic pressures ideally suited for the extrusion type of the forging operations due to the slow speed. Contact time is longer at the die and the metal interface, which causes the problems such as the heat loss from the workpiece and the die distortion. Also provide the close tolerance forging. The hydraulic press, are the more expensive than the mechanical press. So here it is the pictures of the hydraulic press. The compressive fluid is going from this chamber, and this is the chamber of the hydraulic fluid, and this is the motors, and the compressive fluid is operated by this control system, and here it is the ram. So it is going slowly move down. Mechanical press forging. In this, here it is the crank arrangement is present. The crank press translate the rotary motion into the reciprocating linear motion of the press slide. The ram stroke is shorter in the hammer or the than the hydraulic press. This is the path, and the press are the related on the basis of the force developed at the end of the stroke. The blow press is more like crush than like the impact of the hammer. Therefore, the die can be less massive and the die life is longer with the hammer. The total energy supply during the stroke of the press is given by this formula. W is equals to 1 by 2 I omega 0 square minus omega f square. Here it is, the I is the moment of inertia of the flywheel, this flywheel, and the omega is the angular velocity, and the omega 0 represent the original or the initial velocity, and the omega f is the after deformation angular velocity of this flywheel. So this flywheel, this is crank and this is flywheel. So this board or the ram is operated by this arrangement. The ram is up and down with the help of this crank arrangement, and this energy is produced by this arrangement. The typical values of the velocities of the different forging equipments, the forging, these are the forging machines, and these are the velocity range in terms of the meter per second. The gravity drop hammer, its velocity range is 3.6 to 4.8 meter per second. The power drop hammer, its range velocity is 3 to the 9 meter per second, and the HERF, that is the high energy rate forging, its velocity range is 6 to the 24 meter per second, and the mechanical press is obtained the velocity 0.06 to 1.5 meter per second square, means meter per second. The hydraulic press 0.06 to 0.30 meter per second velocity generates. This is the diagram of the open die. This is the open die diagram, and this is the closed die diagram, and this is the impression die forging diagram. In open die forging diagram, these are the two dies, and here it is the initial diameter of the object or the workpiece. When we press from the both sides in the open way, its diameter is increased and the height is reduced. The diameter increase, height reduced. When we apply more pressure on this, so here it is, the diameter is again increased and the height will be short. Here it is the plain type of or flat type of die is used in the open die forging. In the closed die forging, here it is the cavity is formed here, and that this is the shape of the die, and the, according to the shape, the workpiece is in the form of according to the shape. So this is the closed type of forging. And the impression die, it is also the example of the closed die. This is the, according to the shape and size, the die will be prepared. Now the open die forging. The open die forging is the simplest forging operation. Required shape and size of the component is obtained by the changing position of the component between the hammer blows. Although the most open die forging generally weighed 15 to 500 kilogram, forging is the heavy as the 275 metric tons have been made. The part size may be ranged from very small, such like the size of the nail, pins and the bolts, to very large, up to the 23 meters long shaft of the ship propeller. The open die forging can be depicted by the solid workpiece placed between the two flat dies and reduced in the height by the compressing it to process, then also called the upsetting or the flat die forging. The die surface also may be shallow cavities or the incorporate features to produce the relative simple forging. So here it is, in this diagram, the forging of the large turbine shaft and the forging of the pressure vessel cylinders. The open die forging is carried out between the flat die and the dies of the simple shape, and the process is used for the mostly large object when the number of parts produced is small. The open die forging is used to perform the workpiece for the closed die forging. So in this diagram here, it is reduced the diameter with the help of pressing, and in the step wise. So this is the large turbine shaft, and here it is the thickness. Firstly, the diameter this thickness is more in the initial condition when it is pressed in the open die, when it is reduced the thickness of the pressure vessels. Now the second closed die forging. In the closed die forging, the workpiece takes the shape of die cavity while being forged between the two shapes dies. This process usually carried out at the elevated temperature to the lower required force and attain enhanced ductility in the workpiece. The force, the forging pressure is very high and accurate control of the blank volume and proper die design are essential to produce a forging with the desired dimensional tolerance. Undersized blank prevent the complete filling of the die cavities. Conversely, oversized blank generates excessive pressures and may cause die to fall prematurely or the machines to jam. Sorry. The closed die forging or the impression die forging, here it is the workpiece is deformed between the two die halves, which carries the impression on the desired final shape. The workpiece is deformed under the high pressure in the closed cavities. And normally it is used for the small components. The process provides precision forging with the closed dimensional tolerance. The closed dies are the expensive. So here it is the, this is top die and this is the bottom die, and here it is the impression in this die. To prepare the impression in the die according to the requirement of the shapes of the forging object. And this is the component, final component after the pressing in the two dies, in the closed dies forging. Here it is the, initially it is the billet and the pre-shape. This is the pre-shape, this is the shape, and this is the pre-shape. Here it is the three dies are there. So firstly it give the initial shape of the object. Then after the rough forging by the middle type of the die, and after the finishing, the finishing and trimming the object with the help of the third die. So finally we obtain this shape of the final product. And here it is the graph between the forging load and the forging stroke. So here it is, this is the graph in going the upward to downward direction. So this is the complete forging process. The die cavity completely filled, here it is, and the flash begins to form here, and the die contact the workpiece in the initial condition is that. So when the forging stroke is going left hand direction, means increase, then this process is completed. So here it is the completely flashed land object, or this is the flash gluter. The typical, this is the flash to excessive material metals which skewed out of the cavity as a thick ribbon of the metal. Function of the flash. So here it is, the flash serves the two purpose: act as the safety value of the excessive metal and build up the high pressure to the ensure that the metal fill all the recesses of the die cavities. Here it is the upper die and lower die, and this is the forging, and here it is the flush gluter, and this is the flush which is the excess material. It is necessary to achieve the complete fill to the forging cavity without generating excessive pressure against the die that may be caused it is to the fracture. Forging operation is used for the performing operation is used for the forging. So here we already discussed the aging. Second one is the aging method is for collecting the material locally, and second is the blocking method of the producing the approximate shape of the component using the forging. So here it is the shape of the connecting rod, and the finishing method of the producing the exact shape and size of the component. So it is the, and the last one is the training, the method of removing the excess material present in the form of the flash by the cutting operation. So these are the performing operation. Again, the performing operation with the help of example, the set die set and the forging steps for the manufacturing and the automobiles engine connecting rod. The performing of the rod pieces in the open die. So here it is the open die, and the rough shape is formed using the block die. So this is the rough using shape of the block die. To final finish, the die is used to bring the part to final tolerance and the surface finish, removal the excess material, so we obtain the finished product. So here it is the example of the performing operation, the steering knuckle, the rails, here it is the flange, and here it is the metallic cylindrical rod. The closed die design, the using the deformation is the closed die forging is the very complex, and the design of the intermediate step to make the final precision part required the considerable experience and the skill. The design of the part of the production by the closed die forging involves the prediction of. These are the prediction, the workpiece volume and the weight, the number of the performing steps and their configuration, the flash dimensions is the performing and the finishing die and the load and the energy required for each forging operation. For example, the flow stress on the material, the friction condition and the flow of the material in order to develop the optimum geometry of the dies. The forging products in the automobile application, the forged components are the commonly found at the point of the shock and stress. The forged automobile component includes connecting rod, cranks, wheel, spindle, axle beam, piston, gears and the steering arms. The forging are also used to in helicopters, piston engine planes, commercial jets, supersonic military aircraft. The many crafts are the designed around the forging, and the contain more than 450 structural forging, including hundreds of the forging engine parts. And the forge is the mark of the quality in the hand tools and the hardware like pliers, hammers, sledges, wrenches, garden implements and the surgical tools. So here it is the pictures of the IC engine used in automobile. These are the cylinders, sorry, these are the pistons, and this is the connecting rod for the aluminium piston and the connecting rods. Here it is the shape classification according to the degree of the difficulty increase as the geometry is moved toward the right. So here it is the subgroup, or the this is the non-subsidiary element. So here it is the plane type of the element in which the suppose this is the piston structure, simple piston structure. Okay, and here it is the this is the diameter of the piston. This is the shows the diameter of the piston, and here it is the width of the shape of the piston, and here it is the height we show. This is actually denoted by L, lamp. Here it is, the L and B is same, but B is greater than H. So this is the disc-like structure, and in this disc-like structure there is a subsidiary, unisubsidiary element, and with the hub. And here it is in third diagram, the hub with the hole, and in the fourth diagram with the rim, and with rim and the hub. And in this diagram, the disc shape will be the bilateral element, meaning both side with the hubs are present, the hole is there in the hub, and the both side are rimming, and the rimming at the hubs. And now these are the some complicated parts have pronounced the longitudinal axis and the curve in the several planes. This is again, these are the subsidiary elements, and the subsidiary element parallel to the axis of shape, and these are with the open or the closed form elements, and the fourth one is with the subsidiary element asymmetrical of the axis of the principle of shape, and the last with the with two or more subsidiary element with the simpler size. Perform design is the most difficult and the critical steps in the forging design. Proper perform design assured the defects free flow, complete dies fill, and the minimum flash holes. The metal flow consists only the two basics types, the extrusion, the flow parallel to the direction of the die motion, and offsetting flow, the perpendicular to the direction of the die motion. However, both type of metal flow occur simultaneously. We need to identify the neutral surface, since the metal flow away from the neutral surface in the direction perpendicular to the die motion. So here it is the diagram of the upsetting, and this is the initial specimen, and after the upsetting it is the second after the upsetting process. Now this is the finite element analysis of the upsetting of an aluminium cylinder. The finite element analysis was originally developed to model the elastic deformation of the complex structure, but recently have been extended to cover large plastic deformation under the real stress system. It is the numerical model technique that involves the splitting the whole of the body into the series of the simple geometric element, and that is joined together at a point of the knot where the both equilibrium lower bounded and the computable upper bounded is required to establish. So after this is the initial position, and after the forging, the elements will be, the structure is like that. General consideration for the performing design: the area of each cross section is equal to the area of the finishing of the cross section and the flash. The concave radius of the perform, which is always greater than the radius on the final forging part, the cross section of the perform should be higher and the narrow than the final cross section, so as the actuated upsetting flow and the minimum extrusion flow. The shape with the thin and the long section or the projection ribs and the webs are more difficult to the process, because they have the higher surface area per unit volume, increased friction and the temperature effects. Now the general use of the closed die design, the die set should be the design for the smooth metal flow or the symmetric die and the spherical or the block like and are easier than the thin and the long section. The shape change in the section are to be the avoided. The die should be designed for the minimum flush to be the jaw. Generous flits dimension should be allowed. Therefore, the forging dies must be the tapered or the draft to facilitate remove to the finished pieces. The draft allowances is approximately 3 to 5 degree outside and the 7 to 10 degree inside. Here it is. This is the outside allowance, and here it is the inside allowance. The inside one is 7 to 10 degree and the outside is 3 to 5. The die with the inclined angle should be counter locked to prevent the die from the sliding part of each other due to the side thrust. So this is the valve and this is the rib, and these between these two are called the draft angle, and here it is the side thrust of the counter. These are the counter locking part and the side thrust in the direction of left foot. Now the die material, the requirement properties are the thermal shock resistance, thermal fatigue resistance, high temperature strength, high wear resistance, high toughness and ductility, high hardenability, high dimensional stability and the during hardness and the high machinability. So die material are the alloy steel with the chromium and the vanadium, or the tool steel, the cast steel and the cast iron. The heat treatment metals such as the nitride or the chromium platings are required to improve the die life. And here it is the important notes, the carbon steel with 0.7 to 0.85% carbon are appropriate for the small tools and the flat impressions. The medium alloy steel for the hammer dies. And the high alloy steel are the high temperature resistance die used in the press and the horizontal forging machines. These are the die failure and these are the symbols of the failures. This is the symbols of the wear and this is the symbol of thermal fatigue, and the third is the symbol for the mechanical fatigue, and the fourth one is the permanent deformation. Here it is denoted the symbol in this area. Suppose this is the thermal fatigue, this is the wear, and here it is the mechanical fatigue, and here it is the permanent deformation, and so on. The different parts of the die are liable to the permanent deformation and the wear resulting from the mechanical and the thermal fatigue. The important factors: shape of the forging, die material, how the workpiece and the heated and the coating on the die surface and the operating temperature should not be exceed the annealing temperature. Thank you.